Local COVID-19 testing kits are expected to roll out soon. In fact, the Science and Technology Department is eyeing to certify them this week. And here to tell us the latest on the locally made test kits, we have DOST Secretary Fortunato de la Peña. Good morning to you, Secretary de la Peña.
Good morning, Karen, and good morning to everyone.
All right. Well, so far, the latest that I have here is you've already ordered 120,000 test kits. Is that correct? Locally made? Is this still accurate, sir?
Let me just distinguish between a kit and a test. One kit is good for 20 tests. So the 120,000 for which the Manila Healthcare Corporation has the raw materials is actually 120,000 tests.
Okay. So one kit is good for 20 tests.
Yes.
Okay. Is this what kind of test is this? Is this a rapid test? Or
no.
That a PCA test like Senator Gordon's?
This is the PCR test, the polymerase chain reaction test. And this is the gold standard being followed by DOH. So you take a swab, and then this is brought to the PCR laboratory, which is supposed to be a biosafety level 2 laboratory in a hospital. And then the swabs are actually batch. And then it is performed there. The actual test itself is less than 2 hours, but there is batching involved. And then depending also on the capacity of the laboratory or the med tech, because a lot of samples that are submitted, that's the reason why it can exceed, let's say, a 24-hour waiting time. So ideally, it should be 24 hours.
Okay, I'm curious, this is a local company, correct, Secretary? Why did you only order 120,000 test kits? I mean, can't they produce much more?
They can, actually. The 120,000 is the report they gave us as to how much they have ordered and has arrived already. But they can order more raw materials. Now, I just want to clarify that the role of DOST here is the R&D part. So, actually, the team that are doing now the COVID-19 test kit is the same research team from UP National Institutes of Health and also from the Philippine Genome Center, also in UP, who did this studies on the diagnostic kit for dengue and for leptospirosis. As we know, dengue has been commercialized and then leptospirosis is about to be launched. And the researchers actually have put up their own technology-based company in partnership with some others. This is actually provided for in the Technology Transfer Act that we have that researchers can put up their technology company. So they put up Manila Health Tech Corporation. Mm-hmm. Now, the DOST fund that the Office of the President gave us through DBM is 53.2 million pesos that will be good for 26,000 tests or 1,300 kits. Mm-hmm. And so that is, when that is finished, that actually those 1,300 kits good for 26,000 tests will be given for the use of 5 hospitals, namely PGH, Medical City, Baguio General, Vicente Soto in Cebu, and the Southern Philippines Medical Center in Davao, and that is given from the budget that we have. Beyond the 26,000 tests, that will already be commercial production of Manila Health Tech Corporation, and they have informed us that they have many orders already from the private sector intended for donation to hospitals.
Ah, I see. Okay. So just a clarification, this company, the 26,000 tests, that will all be donated to several hospitals. Those are donations or spent by...
The five that I mentioned, it's government money that will be given to those 5 hospitals because they were the first one to respond and to set up the PCR laboratory.
Then I also read that the test kits, these local ones, will be on sale April 3. Is that accurate when they say will be on sale April 3? It gives the impression that ordinary people can buy them. What does that mean exactly?
No. That is not correct. While there can be private sector who can be buying, but this is really intended to be donated also to either to government or DOH or to hospitals. But it is a test that cannot be administered by a person himself. It needs a biosafety level 2 laboratory, and that is a very strict condition of DOH. DOH accredits the hospitals for that, and there is now a list of other hospitals that are on accreditation, and we believe that there will be more hospitals that can do it, but it cannot be administered by the person himself.
Okay. Now, the testing kit is one thing, but do you actually need another kind of machine to read the results? Because Senator Richard Gordon said that Red Cross, for example, other than the kits, they have two machines.
This is the PCR laboratory that I'm referring to,
okay.
The polymerase chain reaction laboratory. It has facilities to do the test for the samples that are brought to the laboratory.
Okay. Secretary, people are calling for mass testing already. Now, of course, there are test kits that are being donated, Jack Ma donated, and many more that are importing from other countries. But how many test kits do you believe we need as a country? Because in South Korea, for example, you're talking about mass testing happens so casually to the point that it's almost like a drive-through. It's a part of their lives. How much tests would we need?
Well, I think it will be DOH who should answer that.
Mm-mm. Okay. All right. So other than the 26,000 test kits, the tests...
Tests,
because one kit is a good pala for 20 tests. Will you have additional orders, sir?
No, the orders that we were informed about, this was already given to us by Manila Healthcare Corporation.
That
there were many orders by big groups or companies who want to donate.
Oo. Tanong ko lang, itong kit na ito, this specific test created by the Philippine company, was this taken from the kit that was designed or the test that was designed by someone from UP?
From where?
From UP. Remember, UP came.
Yeah. Because our the biggest group of our diagnostic kit researchers is from UP, led by Dr. Destura. Actually,
yes.
They have been doing research on diagnostic kits for a number of years already, and so they have more or less the platform already to do diagnostic kits. So as soon as the COVID-19 came about, they readily shifted by January 15 their attention to develop the test kits for COVID-19. And so it is rather fast that they have developed.
Okay. All right. Anything else you'd like to say, Secretary, before we go? Anything you'd like to add?
Yeah, there are many other researches that are ongoing, and it just happened that many of our ongoing researches became very, very relevant because of this need to address COVID-19. So we have, starting middle of next week, we have the VCO trials that will be done in PGH and also in Calabarzon. We have the support of the Philippine Coconut Authority for this because of the known antiviral properties of coconut oil, and that will be done in parallel also with the Ateneo study on lauric acid. This will be in vitro testing in a foreign laboratory which has the facilities, because we want to see how effective coconut oil is and its derivatives to, reduce or diminish the infective property, the infectiveness of the virus.
Yeah, I think that's a brilliant idea, but won't you need more money for that? I mean, you mentioned 53 million. That doesn't sound like a lot.
Actually, these studies will not really need so much if done in the areas that we have already identified. So, for example, in PGH, in the Calabarzon area, where De La Salle University in Dasmariñas is a partner, and we believe that the month-long trials can already give certain indications. After all, the BCO has no harmful effects, and there's no toxicity. So it will be a part of the diet already that will be given to patients, and then see how they respond.
All right. On that note, I want to thank you very much for taking our call, sir. DOST Secretary Fortunato De La Peña. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, Dean Karen.